So hi, what are the steps you need to take when you are selling your two-wheeler or four-wheeler, non-transport vehicle? Generally, what happens is that we sign on the forms that are brought by the purchaser under the advice of some RTA agent. The forms could be Form 28, 29 and 30 and some other documents. The most important step you need to do is to see that the vehicle is transferred in the name of the buyer, which is rarely done until and unless he is taking a loan. He doesn't transfer the vehicle in his name. But you already sold the vehicle. You already gave him the vehicle, delivery of possession. You already took consideration from the purchaser and you already purchased the new vehicle and you are on your job. But he is not transferring the property in his name. He is not transferring the vehicle in his name. Because as per the Motor Vehicles Act, which is the central act, the vehicle can be transferred in any office, transport office, road transport office in India, because it is a central act. So therefore you can't be behind his back and force him to get the vehicle transferred to his name, into his name. Then what is the remedy that is available to you? Because if he commits an accident, you will be summoned by the court because the vehicle is already in your name. The remedy that is very well available in the law is that whenever you sell a vehicle, two-wheeler or the four-wheeler, which is a non-transport vehicle used for personal purpose, you should immediately inform the registering authority of the purchaser. If the registering, the important step you need to take is to know the address of the purchaser. You should record the address of the purchaser and you should just Google it online. You will find the Road Transport Authority, RTA, of the concerned location, of the concerned address, Aadhaar card address of the purchaser. So he gets his property, his vehicle transferred, registered in that location. So you should immediately inform to the Road Transport Authority of the location or of the Aadhaar address of the purchaser. Suppose you are selling the, if you are located in Hyderabad and if your purchaser is in another state like Chennai, and invariably you should obtain the Aadhaar card of the purchaser and then inform the Road Transport Authority that you already sold the vehicle to the purchaser on so and so date and you request the authorities to make the necessary changes in the records. So once you give that information, within 15 days you have to give that information as per section 50 of the Motor Vehicles Act, or within 30 days the purchaser has to inform the authority. If you are not taking any steps to inform the road transport authority within 15 days, or the purchaser is not taking any steps to inform the Road Transport Authority within 30 days, legal action will be initiated by the Road Transport Authority of the area in which the purchaser resides. Once you inform the Road Transport Authority in the purchaser's residence area or the area in which the vehicle is plied, vehicle moves around, your job is over. If that is not done or if that is not taken care of, you will be in problem. Once you inform, if the purchaser doesn't transfer the property into his name, you need not worry because your job is over as per the law. So immediately inform. Regarding forms and all, you can consult the local transport authority where you will get the information where your vehicle was registered. So your vehicle was registered in Hyderabad and the purchaser is intending to register in Chennai. You have to inform the road transport authority of Chennai. As per the procedure, the road transport authority will inform the original authority in Hyderabad in the due course of law. But you did not worry and inform the road transport authority of Hyderabad. You have to inform the road transport authority of Chennai. That is what the law says all about motor vehicle transfer. Thank you.